Straight line SEMSET problems continuation video. Sum number 27. The area of the triangle formed by the lines x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, x sin 18 plus y cos 36 plus 1 is equal to 0. That is, so three lines are given here. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 0 means these are the coordinate axes, and the line is given as this is the line equation, which is x sin 18 plus y cos 36 plus 1 is equal to 0. Now, what is the area of the triangle formed by these lines? What is the formula for finding the area? C square by 2 mod AB. What is C value? Area of the triangle formed by the line AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 with the coordinate axis. This is Y is equal to 0. This X is equal to 0. So formula is equal to C square by 2 mod AB. C is equals to 1 here. 2 into A value sin 18 and B value cos 36. So this is equals to 1 by 2 into sin 18 value root 5 minus 1 by 4 and cos 36 value root 5 plus 1 by 4. Now this is equals to, it is cancelled by 2 times, it is equals to 8 by 5 minus 1, that is 4. So answer is equal to 2. That is the second option. Next, sum number 28. If the straight line perpendicular to 3x minus 4y minus 6 is equal to 0 forms a triangle with the coordinate axis whose area is equal to 6, then the equation of the straight line is equal to the straight line perpendicular to the given line. So what is the given line here? 3x minus 4y minus 6 is equal to 0. Now we want the equation of the line perpendicular to this one. What is the perpendicular line formula? Bx minus ay plus k is equal to 0. That is, b is equal to minus 4, a is equal to 3. That is, the line is minus 4x minus 3y plus k is equal to 0. Means this is 4x plus 3y minus k is equal to 0. Now what is given? Area of the triangle formed with this line where the coordinate axis is equal to 6 here. That is given that c square by 2 mod ab is equal to 6. Area of the triangle is equal to 6. Replacing the value, c is equal to k. K square by 2 into 4 into 3 is equal to 6. That is, k square is equals to 24 into 6, 144. Therefore, the value of k is equal to plus or minus 12. Therefore, the equation is 4x plus 3y plus or minus 12 is equal to 0. So answer is 4x plus 3y equals to 12. That is the correct answer. Next, sum number 29. The equation of the base of the equilateral triangle is x plus y is equal to 2 and the vertex is equal to 2 comma minus 1. Then what is the area of the triangle? So one triangle is given here. Equation of the base of an equilateral triangle. So x plus y is equal to 2. This is the base of the equilateral triangle and the vertex is equal to 2 comma minus 1. So this is the point not satisfied by this equation. So we take the point as the opposite vertex. Since this is the point not lies on this line, so we take the point like that. Now the area of the triangle is equal to, area of the equilateral triangle is equal to formula p square by root 3. Area of the equilateral triangle is equal to p square by root 3. What is p value? P is nothing but the perpendicular distance from vertex to its opposite side. That is, p is equal to perpendicular distance. Substituting this point in the line equation, 2 minus 1 minus 2 pi, root a square plus p square. That is equal to root 2. So p value is equal to 1 by root 2. Therefore, area is equal to, what is the formula? P square by root 3. That is 1 by 2 by root 3. That is equals to 1 by 2 root 3. So taking the rationalization, option is not given like that. So taking the rationalization, so this is equals to 1 by 2 root 3 into root 3 by root 3. That is, the answer is root 3 by 6. That is the second option. Next, sum number 30. The quadrilateral formed by the lines 2x minus 5y plus 7 is equal to 0, 5x plus 2y minus 1 equal to 0, 2x minus 5y plus 2 is equal to 0 and 5x plus 2y plus 3 is equal to 0. Rectangle, square, parallelogram, rhombus, these are the options. So see here, the first two lines are perpendicular lines and next two lines are perpendicular. That is, every set of edges and sides are perpendicular and 1 and 3 are parallel, 2 and 4 are parallel. So I draw the diagram like that. So this is the first line is 2x. Diagram of the given lines. First line is 2x minus 5y plus 7 is equal to 0. And the third line is 2x minus 5y plus 2 is equal to 0. Second one, 5x plus 2y minus 1 is equal to 0. 4th when 5x plus 2y plus 3 is equal to 0. Now here, see here these two lines are perpendicular to each other. A1 A2 plus B1 B2 is equal to 0, 10 minus 10. Here also A1 A2 plus B1 B2 is equal to 0, 10 minus 10. That is the lines are perpendicular. So lines are perpendicular means here the angles are 90 degrees. So this is either rectangle or square. Now finding the distance between the parallel lines. What is the distance between these two parallel lines? Modulus of C1 minus C2. 7 minus 2 by square root of A square plus B square. Root 29. That is 5 by root 29. And what is the distance between these two parallel lines? This is equals to minus 1 minus 3. That is minus 1 minus 3 by C1 minus C2. Square root of 25 plus 4. 29. So this is 4 by root 29. That is the distances are not equal means it is a rectangle. If these two distances are equal, then we take that this is the square. But here the distance is not equal, so it is a rectangle. Next, sum number 31. The diagonals of a parallelogram PQRS about the lines is equal to x plus 3y is equal to 0, 6x minus 2y is equal to 7. So x plus 3y is equal to 4, 6x minus 2y is equal to 7 means, what is the slope of this line? Minus 1 by 3. What is the slope of this line? 3. That is, here m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. That is, the two diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Two diagonals are perpendicular to each other means it is a rhombus. So, clearly here the two diagonals are perpendicular to each other. That is, the given lines form a rhombus. That's all.